Sir Galahad stooped down and said, "Now let him be revealed, for we must know the truth before this evil can be healed." So he unlaced the Dark Knight's helm and stood back all amazed. It was no more a human face, the sight on which they gazed. Beneath the mask of hardened steel, no human face remained. Just springs and bolts and cogs and wheels, all rusty, worn and stained. And from his fallen form there came a sad mechanic sound, the sound of dark machinery, all slow and winding down. "Can this be?" the Naiad cried. "He once was flesh and blood, and once I thought a maiden's love might do the poor man good. I see," sighed good Sir Galahad, "the trap he set himself. He set his mind on turning cogs, he set his heart on wealth. Where he set his mind and heart, his soul flowed in their wake. For sometimes we ourselves become the idols that we make." "He spurned your love, alas, that love was all that kept him whole. And soon a mechanistic will became a clockwork soul. To the fate he chose, for we must find the key, the iron key that closes first, and then the golden key." They sought throughout the castle grim, they opened many doors, and freed from chains and drudgery the helpless and the poor. "I fear this place," the Naiad said, "the place where I was bound. I fear what might become of me before the key is found." Fear not," said Galahad, "your tyrant is no more, and you'll find the courage to unlock the dreadful door. Find the key that once held you so fast, and only you can heal this place and make that healing last. Draw up from deep within yourself the hidden flow and force, the wellspring of your inner life, the source behind the source.